Why did you choose a coolie to be the hero? Why not a paanwala or a dabbawala?
Because when you go to the VT station, the Bombay Central Station, you see these coolies lined up, smoking bidi. They're sitting in a row. There is very good enmity between them. They have no fight between them. They're all so well organized. कि सबकी earnings शाम को same होती है. जो भी एक आदमी ज़्यादा किया वो उनको they divide the earnings. The way they sit, the red cloth, white dhoti or white pyjama, it looks very fascinating. फिर वो brass का billa, it's a very lovely sight. It's a very beautiful visual image. So I said, why not show the life of a coolie? People have shown rickshaw wala's, party wala's, some other profession, bartender like Anthony. No, why not coolies? And believe me, people have gone when coolie is the biggest hit of our career, my career so far. So as a producer, so as a result of this film's release in Indore and Sumitville, India, coolies used to go in numbers wearing the coolie dresses and get themselves photographed in front of the theater, and they used to send this photograph to us in the office. And I remember in Delhi, I got my distribution office there, and the first few weeks, the theater had to keep compulsory shows only for the coolies early morning at 7 o'clock. They said, we cannot stand in the line in the advance booking because we are at the station. We want a separate show for ourselves. We used to rent separate shows for the coolies. They used to pay the money, but have shows at 7 in the morning.
Do you think you became a bit crude with Mard?
I don't think so. I found Mard was a fabulous entertainer. It had tempo like never before. It had some sequences. It was so marvelous, this shot. It was nothing but Phantom. What is Phantom? You read this comic strip Phantom. Man with the mask. He has a dog and he has a horse. Rex and Devil. I brought a Phantom. Now, every Indian film is showing fight with smugglers or corruption or politicians and this and that. I said, now look, why not I go change the villain angle, bring them pre-independence. So I went for the Britishers. So I had to put every conceivable gimmick in there to make it interesting. And I think it was superbly edited, superbly shot film, and it's proved by the success of the box office that the film has been a great success. And so, like a sequence like The Dog in India is not allowed. I think it's a fantastic sequence.
What about the crudity like Tambu Mein Bambu?
No, this is not crudity. This is a folk song. This is a folk song. There was a folk song even in Sangam. Main kya karu Ram mujhe buddha mil gaya. But nobody would say that. There was a mere angne mein tumhara kya kaam hai. There's again a folk song from UP. And if I bring a folk song, they say it's crude. There is nothing crude about Mard. It's absolutely a very polishedly, very brilliantly shot film, in my opinion. And I stand by that statement any day.
But suppose you sing Tambu Mein Bambu, won't it sound a bit titillating? You
know? So what? Damn it, the film was made for the masses. It's made for the kids, made for the masses. What's wrong in that? There is nothing titillating about it. It's how you view it.
Can you sing us Tambu Mein Bambu?
All right. Hum to tambu mein bambu lagaye baithe. Hum to tambu mein bambu lagaye baithe. हम तो तंबू में बंबू लगाए बैठे हैं. हम तो तंबू में बंबू लगाए बैठे लगाए बैठे लगाए बैठे. हम तो तंबू में तंबू बंबू में लंबू तंबू में बंबू लगाए बैठे. It's a nice song. It's a nice catchy number. Then there's nothing wrong with it.
Do you miss singers like Mohammed Rafi and Kishore Kumar?
How I miss. I miss them so badly. Like Rafi, I'm a bhagat of Mohammed Rafi. And I feel his Ross is irreplaceable. Irreplaceable. Ever since Mr. Mohammed Rafi died, I've been at a loss for male singing, you know. With Mukesh ji, at least their voice suited to Mr. Raj Kapoor so well. But even with Kishore going now, there is a total dearth of male playback singing in this country. With the result, what have I done? In Ganga Jamuna Saraswati, I have put a lot of female songs. At least we have this, the greatest of them all, Mr. Lata Mangeshkar, you have Asha Bhosle. So these singers are there for female singing. Who is going to sing for the male heroes? So now the problem is from where to get good male singers.
How does the music and lyrics of today compare with the earlier era?
Oh, the music was the greatest in the 40s and 50s. It was the renaissance in the golden period of music, there was melody. Films were made only for music. As I read somewhere, Mr. Navshad once commented very beautifully, that in those 40s and 50s, people used to come to hear songs and then leave the auditorium. Nowadays, when the songs come, the audience is out. The quality of songs have suffered. Now, for this, you cannot blame the music directors alone. The taste of the public has changed. The films have changed. There used to be love stories in 40s and 50s, family dramas. Now, you've got action-based stories. Now, in action-based stories, it's very difficult to bring that type of music. If you bring it, people will get up. Jaise kehte, waisi, if you want good music, good melody of music, uske liye mahol, you have to create an atmosphere for it, right from the word go. So in Ganga Jamuna Saraswati, the music is melodious. It's, we have emphasized on melody and lyrics. Now, Ram Teri, Ganga Valley, it's got tremendous musical value, very rich lyrics. Picture ka mahol was set that way. So I've done the same thing in Ganga Jamuna with outstanding melodious music. It all depends on the subject. Now, you cannot have an action subject and have melodious music. The people would immediately walk out.
But do we have good music composers today, really?
Today, the only one left, the best of them is Lakshmikant Peralam. As I said once in my article that my favorite has been Naushad, the all-time great, the greatest of all times. Then Shankar Jigishan, and then Lakshmikant Peralam. These three have been my all-time favorites. But that doesn't mean there have been other composers whose work have been brilliant, like C. Ramchandra, S. D. Burman, sometimes songs of Mr. Roshan, Mr. Madan Mohan. They've all been brilliant composers. At that time, it was very difficult to compete. I mean, there was real good competition. You had about 7 to 8 top music directors, and each one would vie with the other, and there was a very healthy competition. With the result, the best music came out in 40s and 50s.
So why didn't you work with Lakshmikant Peralam?
They have a lot of work on their hand. And I'm afraid, now traveling all the way to suburb takes me, I stay in the city, takes me 1 hour, 15 minutes. And because of my back trouble, I travel in a van, or a van made for that. And I don't have the patience to go 1.5 hours there, 1.5 hours coming. And I do not know whether the sitting will take place or not. Plus, now I've come to an age when I would like things to happen at my convenience. I would like to bank upon other people's convenience. I would like to sit. I would like to have sittings, and I want to have sittings. I would like to record songs, and I want to record songs, not when they want to record songs. Not after paying people their dues or overdues. I pay them more than others, and still I have to wait in the line and queue. I'm afraid I'm not going to stand that for anybody in this trade, for any artist or for any technician.
Can you talk about novelty items? Where does it come from? And which do you think have been your most successful novelty items?
Bluff Master at Govinda Alareala, Amar Abhinantani at this Kavali. Of course, Kavalis have come and gone before. But the very popular Kavali, very superb number Lakshmikant had given. I think the best Kavali in the film industry is coming Amar Abhinantani after Zenith. One of the old film called Zenith. Aayana Bhare Shikwena Ke Phir Bhi Zubaan Pe Naam Aaya. After that, this was the best Kavali. It was beautifully picturized. My dance director Kamal played a very important part. Beautiful situation with the participation of Amitabh in it. The whole thing went off beautifully. It had a lot of novelties. Then the climax song, where all the three in three get-ups, one dressed as a priest, the other as a bandmaster, the third as a Muslim character, they all sing. So a lot of, in Naseeb, I had this revolving restaurant, I had the glass house, I had the boxing ring. In Naseeb, that's why I prefer Naseeb to be my best of all my lot, because it had, as I said, it had tremendous buffet items. You pick up any reel of Naseeb and it's a pleasure to see. The presentation, I don't think anybody has ever presented a film, you know, in this manner before.
What about Coolie's radio?
Yeah, that also, you know, is taken from some play. Somebody told me, one of my assistants told me there's a play like that, TV play or some play, where the bands of a radio get mixed, you know, somebody preaching yoga, somebody saying something. And so we utilized that idea and brought it in Coolie.
Do you get inspired by any foreign directors? Who are your favorites?
At the moment, I think Spielberg is the greatest of all times. After seeing Empire of the Sun, I feel the man is the greatest of the century. Otherwise, my favorite has been Billy Wilder. I've acknowledged him to be the god of scripting and as director. Then there have been David Lean. There have been several others. But after seeing Spielberg's film now, I feel this man is the last word. He knows his medium so well. He doesn't need a script. He doesn't need stars, he doesn't need script, he doesn't need anybody except himself. He picks up any child and brings a beautiful script, beautiful taking, good special effects. That's it.
Could you ever do something like that?
Of course, I cannot even touch it. I cannot even think of trying to imitate him. But I'll tell you one thing. The day I ever get a chance to shoot abroad an English film with their technicians, with their optical labs, their special effects, the stunt directors, I can give them a run for their money. Because what they are making is practically the same thing that we have been making in India. Emotions, action. We can do it. All I need is a chance which I've never got. Give me one chance. Let me make three films. And my heart tells me, my mind tells me, two of them will click in a big way.
Why can't you get the chance?
Nobody's offering me.
You have the money.
No, I don't have the money. You need lots of... If you have money in rupees, what are you going to do with money abroad? You need millions and millions of dollars. Who's going to back me up? Once some person had agreed to back me about 5 years back, but then he backed out. For reasons best known to him. He was an outsider. Now, if I ever get a chance to do a film abroad, just give me a chance. I and my son will create a havoc their income. That's a promise.
What kind of a project was this?
I was making a typical Hindi action. But you see, when you see Spielberg's films, it resembles a lot of Indian films. There's a friendship angle. You see E.T., friendship between a monster, ugly monster and a child. You see Empire of the Sun, it is lost and found. He's on my home ground. So a lot of things I feel, Spielberg studies Indian sentiments, he knows human emotions well. And that's what's clicking abroad.
Why don't you want the audience to think?
Pardon?
Why don't you want the audience to think?
No, I don't want to think. I don't want to let them think at home. They are coming to the auditorium. They are spending 8 rupees basically not to think. They are coming to see and hear. That's not a place for thinking. They are coming to get themselves entertained. So our job is to see that they are fully entertained. They can do a lot of thinking on the way back home or on the way to the theater. They have a lot of time and all the time in the world to think and think and think.
Why are you hostile to new wave cinema? I mean, they are doing their own thing.
I am not hostile to anybody. As a matter of fact, I hope these new cinema people appreciate that I am the only director in this country who's praised film like Tamas no end. When I saw Tamas on TV, I thought that Govind Nilani is the greatest director India has got at the moment, and I stand by the statement. As in Ketan Mehta's work, Mirch Masala, he's superb. Shyam Benegal, their works are superb, but that did not necessarily mean all the cinemas made by New Wave is great. Just because they are serious cinema, you can't say they are great cinemas. Just because somebody makes a boring film, I can't say this is a good film. But Tamas is not my type of film. He's not an entertainer, but it is mind-boggling, the film. It's superb in concept and execution. Now, what have I got to do with Govind Nilani? Still, I praise his work. You can ask him. Send him flowers. Because I would like to see the film. And if I enjoy a film, I'll say it's good. Not because somebody tells me to say it's good. I do not want to be a hypocrite. So if I don't like a film, if I don't like a new wave film, I'll say it's bullshit. Now, that doesn't mean that all commercial cinemas are good. We make a lot of bullshit ourselves. Maybe we are making more than them. But then at least we have the guts to admit it.
What happened to the love story of a call girl you wanted to make?
Yeah, that's it. It remained my dream. Now that I'm quitting as a director with Ganga Jamuna Saraswati due to my back trouble, I'm hoping my son makes that film. I would definitely make that film, Lovebirds. One day in the not too distant future, this project will go through.
Do you ever read comics?
I used to. Read a lot of comics.
What kind?
Oh, spy. Archie comics. I actually read spy thrillers. Like you used to get what you call commando comics that come from England. Good plots. It's got good plot.
Do you get inspired?
Yes, sometimes I do. I get a sequence from there. Can you believe small little comic book of 30 pages has the full, with the visuals, you get the full satisfaction you have seen the full picture in that.
Have you ever marred visuals?
No, I haven't marred. The only time I've marred something is in Rampurga Lakshman, I flicked a sequence from the Sicilian clan. It was inspired from the Sicilian clan.
You took stock footage of the plane landing.
I don't know what my producer did. I left it to him.
What conclusions have you drawn about show business? What is it really like?
Show business is a great business. It used to be really great in 50s, 60s and 70s. But now, with the advent of video, the technology, with the TV coming in a big way, the illegal video piracy, the cable TVs, the illegal video parlors, the show business is coming to an end. There won't be any show left in the show business. Unless somehow some scheme is formed, the government somehow realizes that we have to exist like they have to exist. If they can formulate a scheme whereby the illegal earnings of video parlors are channelized back into the film trade to the distributor and the producer, there's no scope for us to exist now.
But why is there a boom in film production?
There is always, they say the candle flickers the brightest when it's about to extinguish. I feel it's the same thing. It's bright, is it the it is the flame is burning is brightest at the moment with an overflow, overproduction of films. It's a big balloon. It just needs one little prick and it's going to burst.
Can you talk about the special language in your film, the street language?
I use it in Anthony. In Amar Par Anthony, I use the language which Anthony spoke. Kya Akbar kidhar hi che? Zara dikhta hi che nahi yaar. Kidhar tum idhar hi che rehta hai ke Bargaon gaya yaar? Kidhar hi che? This typical Bombay language which a Catholic speaks. So I used to hear this language in my streets and I put it.
Have you developed this language?
No, but at least I think I'm the first one to bring it on the screen. Later on, people have started doing that. It went well with that character Anthony, but you cannot use that language with everybody in every film.
Can you talk about your behavior with the stars? How do you all talk? Like, what would a conversation between you and Amitabh be on a set? Can you enact that?
Sometimes it's unprintable language. Doordarshan will never allow it. We have a good rapport. We have no complexes about shooting. He doesn't feel the big star. I don't feel I'm a director. I like with all my artists when I work, I first put them at ease. Look, we are here to work, but in a good condition. There's no question of getting tensed, no question of becoming serious, no question of posing. There's a word, I can never pose. There are directors who start posing and thinking. You have to come prepared. And you work, you have to come there for 8 hours, put everybody at ease, have fun, have a light moment, and you get your work done nicely. And that's how I've been able to get my work done.
But you can't tell us how you direct a shot.
No, for that you must come and see it yourself. I can't tell you. But you, some most of the clipping you have to leave it because you can't use the language that I speak on the set with the male artist.
Do you click more with the males than the females?
Yeah, because my language is easier. With the females, I'll be very conscious that no wrong word slips out. So I'm very conscious of that fact.
Are you more at ease with your male stars than with your female stars?
That's right. I'm more at ease with my male stars than female stars because there is back slapping. There is fun. You can make fun of somebody. You can take a joke, you can crack a joke, you can take it on, you can give it back to him. With female stars, it's very, very difficult. I like to draw a line of respect between us.
Do you think it'll be possible for your son, Ketan, to emerge out of your shadow?
Oh, yes. I feel my son will excel me. That is, there's one field where he's going to excel me in dialogues and the performances, the way he enacts a scene and shows the artist. I don't think anybody in this state does it unless he's an actor himself. That's why I feel my son should click if God is kind to him. Now, I don't know what is destined for him. But if destiny is kind to me, I hope it's kind to him. And if his luck clicks, he will make beautiful films. And he will be, the glorious tradition of MKD will go on. Not that he will do only films of my type. He's quite versatile. He's young. He's got modern ideas. He will try to project them in his films. But dialogues and performances will be the high point in his films.
But do you think you pushed him into films? Didn't he want to be something else?
No. He wanted to be in films. He joined me. My son joined me in the films at the age of 15. He passed his SSC at the age of 15. At the age of 15 and a half, he joined me in Parvarish. He was looking after my production. A big, giant movie like Naseeb. This is a real multicast movie. When I talk about multicast movies, Naseeb was a multicast movie. He single-handedly managed the days of all the artists for 3 years. The full credit to that boy for ending the production.